As the teachings of his master flooded his mind, Teku opened his eyes. In front of him, he saw all the stars in the firmament. Suddenly, he heard a fire crackling nearby. The last thing he remembered were the voices of alarm. His home was being attacked. Then, he staggered to his feet. There was no time to lose. Teku couldn't go on. It was too dark. Oh no! That poor man told Teku what happened. The tribe of the Wakcha had attacked the village and captured prisoners. One of them was Yaka, the tribe's shaman. He had to do something.
Kumungu Shakapaka.
Before going in. Wake up, Teku. Come on. It was a Wakcha warrior. But unfortunately, there was no trace of the shaman. It's possible that the main group had gone on ahead. He had to be careful. They were very dangerous. On the stove.
Thank you.
He had heard stories. Is coming after Teku. Deku immediately.
Paina, paina, chinga.
Papalote a Calacrán. Pacheco Chaxa Tomeco.
Palupo, Gustiña en Pinopo.
Recognized that strange object. It was one of the masks the ancient warriors had placed on their mounts. Those huge beasts were known as Daiwus, and it had been centuries since any had been seen.
Thank you.
Underneath the corpulent Toad King was one of the coins Teku needed to use the boat. Now Teku only had to find the second coin and bring it to the old lady. Teku gave the last coin to the old lady. Lady would be waiting on the dock until Teku decided to leave. Mesmerized by the light of the flash, the strange insect turned to Teku. Deeply grateful, the mother monkey offered to help Teku climb up to the treetops.
Thank you.
They waited until the rainwater soaked the strange seed. Suddenly, the ground started to vibrate. Amazing! Shaman. He had finally found him. The Watchers carried him inside that cave. Tekka would have to find a way of getting the gigantic stone door open again. Started to boil. Tekka already had one of the ingredients he needed for the ritual.
Chuta, chuta, kala! Chuta kala!
appeared to be. If there's no other choice. Without asking for anything in return, that troubled man had ground up the pearl in his mortar.
Thank you.
Teku studied them. Now.
Chuta, cala!
Hanging from the belt of the warrior, Teku could see a bunch of keys. Thank you. Teku, climb up here. Get back! Mask seat. The ancients. Wakcha had taken Yakka inside the temple. Teku had to find a way to activate the bridge again so he could cross.
Ah!
It didn't fit. Thank you.
Choco.
kukri.
Timit. Timit.
Choco.
Kukri. Kukri.
Kukri.
Choco. Timit.
Choco.
Kukri. Kukri.
Choco.
Timit.
Kukri.
Timit.
Kukri. Timit.
Kukri.
Teku was surprised to see that the Wactures had also been taken prisoner. Something very strange was happening. Thank you. This is the mechanism. As the last prisoners were escaping through the window, Teku turned to the shaman. He could tell that something was happening. Something strange. Why were the Wakcha being captured and sacrificed like everyone else? Who were those strange hooded ones guarding the temple? Teku couldn't understand why his enemies would worship a creature that was annihilating them. But above all, he asked himself why the gods had created this monster who obliged them to commit terrible acts. I'll go on ahead. Now, Teku, activate the altar! Behold, Teku, the fire of the gods is burning on the mountain again. And now what? Asked Teku. Now comes the most difficult part, starting over. The world as we knew it has ended. The tribes will be at peace once more, and our people will no longer have to hide. But most of all, we must not let our errors be forgotten. We will rebuild our village, Teku. The fire of the gods must burn again in the temples. So today, this tiny candle you're holding means